The second orbital test flight of the Starship concluded several days ago, but the fascinating tales surrounding it continue to captivate. It will undoubtedly be analyzed and discussed for months, if not years, to come. One of the remarkable achievements of this flight was the sight of 33 engines igniting simultaneously after liftoff, a feat never before accomplished by any other vehicle. However, there is another aspect that makes these 33 Raptor engines truly extraordinary. Not only did they generate incredible thrust, but they also produced awe-inspiring shock diamonds, a phenomenon unparalleled by any other rocket or plane. How did the recent Starship flight achieve this marvel, and what can we learn from that moment? Let's explore all of this on today's episode of Science of Space. Following the initial orbital test flight, SpaceX encountered numerous challenges, with one of the most significant and apparent being the issues with the Raptor engines in the Super Heavy booster. Specifically, some engines failed to operate after the Starship took off. Visually, the fact that certain engines did not ignite like the rest diminished the impressiveness of the flight. On a technical level, engine problems greatly affected the performance of the flight. Over the past 7 months, SpaceX has made crucial upgrades to its Starship prototype, particularly focusing on the engine. The engine plays a vital role in the spacecraft's performance and safety, undergoing over 1,000 modifications since the last flight. What were these changes, and why are they significant? The answer became evident during the second orbital test flight of the Starship. The 33 Raptor engines and the Super Heavy booster functioned flawlessly, from liftoff until just before the separation phase. This stability allowed the flight to achieve new milestones, especially considering its longer duration and higher altitude, compared to the previous flight. The moment, when all 33 engines were working simultaneously in the initial minutes of the flight, was truly awe-inspiring. It's no wonder that this incredible sight has been widely shared on social media platforms. But that's not the only impressive thing about the Starship's Raptor engines. They also created a stunning phenomenon known as the shock diamond. SpaceX shared these breathtaking images in slow motion after the flight, giving us a chance to truly appreciate their beauty. You might have missed it during the flight, as we were all caught up in the excitement. But this was a truly unique feat. The 33 engines combined to create a series of magnificent shock diamonds, something that no rocket or aircraft has ever achieved before. So, what exactly are shock diamonds and how do they come about? Shock diamonds, also known as Mach diamonds, are patterns of standing waves that appear in the supersonic exhaust plume of aerospace propulsion systems like jet engines and rockets. When these systems operate in an atmosphere, the diamonds become visible due to abrupt changes in density and pressure within the exhaust. Here's how it happens. When the engine is activated, it releases a burst of energy to propel the rocket upwards. This energy stream creates a supersonic exhaust flow. However, the exhaust gas is slightly overexpanded, resulting in its pressure being lower than the surrounding air pressure. As the exhaust gases flow out of the nozzle, the high pressure of the surrounding air compresses them. These external compressive forces, caused by shock waves, create an oblique angle with the flow. The compressed flow then alternately expands through parallel expansion fans, forming each diamond. The pairing of an oblique shock with an expansion fan gives rise to these stunning formations. When the compressed flow becomes parallel to the center line, a shock wave perpendicular to the flow is formed, known as a normal shock wave. This will determine the initial location of the first shock diamond from the engine nozzle. The distance between them is known as the zone of silence. This distance is calculated using a formula, 67 multiplied by the nozzle diameter, then multiplied by the square root of the flow pressure, divided by atmospheric pressure. As the exhaust gas passes through the normal shock wave, the temperature of the gas stream increases, resulting in excess fuel burning and the formation of a prominent diamond-shaped light. Eventually, the flow will expand again, with its pressure becoming lower than the surrounding air pressure. At this point, the expansion fan reflects from the contact discontinuity or the outer edge of the flow. The reflected waves, or compression fan, can create another oblique shock wave, leading to the formation of a second shock diamond. This cycle continues as long as the air remains perfect and nothing slows it down. This phenomenon is more commonly observed in high-performance jets or supersonic aircraft, due to their extremely fast speeds, which generate supersonic airflow at low pressure. However, during the last flight of the Starship, this phenomenon was particularly remarkable. The shock diamond produced by its 33 engines, divided into three rings, was the largest ever seen. The Starship's tremendous thrust, reaching up to 7,590 tons or 16.7 million pounds, propelled it to a maximum speed of 5,664 kilometers per hour, before separating. Following the principle of shock diamond formation, each engine created its own small shock diamond effect. The 33 engines of the Super Heavy booster worked in unison to create a single, powerful energy flow. Essentially, these 33 individual engines combined to form one massive engine, resulting in a huge supersonic exhaust flow at low pressure. This phenomenon, known as the shock diamond formation principle, produced a series of stunning diamond-shaped effects that we can see here. This moment is a testament to the incredible power of the Raptor engine. Developed by SpaceX, the Raptor 2 engine has achieved remarkable feats in the field of rocket propulsion. It can produce an impressive 230 tons or 510,000 pounds of thrust, making it one of the most powerful engines in the world. In fact, it has set a new record for the highest chamber pressure ever reached by a rocket engine at 300 bars. Surpassing the previous record held by its predecessor, the Raptor 1, which itself broke the long-standing record held by the Russian RD-10. The Raptor 2 engine is a relatively new invention, having started production at the end of 2021 and flown only twice. This is truly a remarkable achievement in the world of rocket science. Despite being relatively new, it has already established itself as a leader in the aerospace industry. The recent flight not only set a record for the most engines operating simultaneously, surpassing even the N1 rockets, but also showcased stunning images with shock diamonds. This achievement is unprecedented and sets SpaceX apart from any other rocket. With the upcoming launch of Raptor 3, new records are expected to be created. In a test conducted in May, it achieved a thrust of up to 269 tons, and a chamber pressure of 350 bars. If this engine version is used, it is likely to outperform its predecessor, Raptor 2, and create an even more impressive moment. SpaceX never fails to surprise us with the miracles they perform. Their progress is not only rapid and powerful, but they also leave an unforgettable impression. The recent flight's sighting of the shock diamond phenomenon is a perfect example of this. However, as SpaceX continues to repeat these achievements, we may eventually become accustomed to them. Nevertheless, SpaceX's strides, especially with the Raptor engine, are happening swiftly and with great momentum. Elon Musk and SpaceX's engineers will not stop there. They will continue to develop other engines that are even more powerful and impressive, pushing the boundaries of what we thought was possible. With these engines, SpaceX will continue to achieve significant milestones in the aerospace industry. Their next target is orbit, followed by the Moon, Mars, and beyond. But before reaching those milestones, there is still much to accomplish. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.